Good morning, everyone. We are continuing here in the words of the Kitzur Shulchan Aruch, and we're starting today a new Simen. Chapter, Simen Kuf 100, Hilchas Nesias Kapayim, the laws of Birchas Kohanim, the blessings that the Kohen gives to the congregation. And this is also part of the laws of Yom Tiv, because as we'll see, that outside Eretz Yisrael and in the Ashkenazi communities, Birchas Kohanim is something that is reserved for Yom Tiv, for the holidays. So the Torah commands Aaron HaKohen and his children that they should bless the people with what we call Birchas Kohanim, the priestly blessing. As it says in the Torah, Yivarechecha Hashem v'yishmerecha, Yoyer Hashem panav eilecha v'yichunecha, Yisa Hashem panav eilecha v'yisem lecha shalom. Which means that Hashem should, the Kohanim are blessing the people with the following brachas. Hashem should bless you and safeguard you. Hashem should illuminate His countenance for you and be gracious to you. And Hashem should lift His countenance to you and establish peace for you. And that's what we're going to be discussing over here, the obligations of the Kohanim and how the Birchas Kohanim is done, so that when Shavuos will arrive in just a few weeks, and you are in shul, and you hear them say, Kohanim, when they say, they call the Kohanim, and they're doing the bracha to the Jewish people, will understand what they're doing. Mitzvahs esei minatoyah ala Kohanim, there is a positive commandment from the Torah. And it is a biblical commandment, sheyivarchu es ha'am, to bless the Jewish people. Shenema, like it says, koyisivarchu es b'nei Yisrael. It says, so too you should bless the b'nei Yisrael, the children of Israel. V'kol kohen, every kohen, she'ein boi midvarim hama'akvim oisei. Any kohen that does not have what we would call a mum, he doesn't have a blemish that we will see later on in halacha, what that means. So any kohen that is blemishless, and he has no disqualifying factors that makes him not permitted to give the bracha. If he doesn't come up at that time to duchen, which means over here to give over the blessings, he has violated a positive commandment. However, he only violates the commandment if they called him to give the priestly blessing. Shenema, like it says, Amar lehem, it says the following, that you should say to the Kohanim. The Targum Unklas, Kad Yemun Lohin, it says, when you say to them, which means that when you tell the Kohanim to come and to give a bracha, that is when they are going to get up there to give the bracha. So the Kohanim have a mitzvah's essay, the rice over here, of giving the bracha, but they have to be spoken to and told to give it. The custom in our countries, which means outside the land of Israel, and according to the Ashkenazim, we only do Birchas Kohanim on Yom Tov. Why? Because we are in a state of great happiness because of Yom Tov. And even though that Yom Kippur is a day that we are being, there's a very serious Yom HaDin, a day of judgment. Nevertheless, we're being forgiven and atoned for our sin and all of our sins. That's a great simcha. V'tayv leiv hu yivarech. And he quotes a verse over here which says, only the person who has a good spirit, a happy spirit, is able to give a bracha. And therefore, mashe'en kein, b'shar yamim, the other days of the year, afilu b'shabbos ha'shan, even on regular Shabbos of the year, she'trudim b'hihurim al michyusam, we're busy thinking about how we're going to earn a living, and we're stressed out. The albita malachtam, and when even on Shabbos we're thinking, oy vey, I'm not working. How am I going to make money? Even on Yom Tov, we don't make a bracha. We don't do Birchas Kohanim by Shachris and Musaf, only by Musaf. Why? She yoytzin achar kach beis agneses veyismichu besimchas Yom Tov, because after Musaf is over, people are going home. And they know they're going to eat, they're going to drink, they're going to be happy, and therefore they can go revel in the Simchas Yom Tov and the happiness of Yom Tov. Furthermore, the custom in our country is Yom Tov shechalios b'Shabbos. When Yom Tov falls out on Shabbos, ein nesias kapayim ela b'Yom Kippurim. We only do nesias kapayim on Yom Kippur. Sheafilu chal b'Shabbos nesias kapayim, even on Yom Kippur, if it falls out on Shabbos, you would do Birchas Kohanim. However, there are those that have the custom, every Yom Tov, even if it falls out on Shabbos, the minhag really is, and this is our custom as well, that when Shabbos, Yom Tov falls out on Shabbos, we still do Nesias Kapayim. As we'll see though, there's a little bit of less things that are said on Shabbos because of the people's tension on the Shabbos. On the other hand, when it's Yom Tov, Yom Tov is a day of great simcha for the Jewish people, and therefore we're on that elevated state to give the bracha, and that's why Birchas Kohanim is then. The Sfardim and in Eretz Yisrael, they hold that there's an opportunity to do the mitzvah over here of Birchas Kohanim, which is a mitzvah deraisa, we're not going to miss out, and therefore, even if a person is not in 100% of happiness and joy the way that he would be on a Yom Tov, nevertheless, he still has a mitzvah to give over the bracha, and therefore the Sfardim and even the Ashkenazim in Eretz Yisrael, they will do Birchas Kohanim every single day. Have a wonderful day. We shall continue Be'ez Hashem tomorrow.